If you're considering a career in healthcare and you're trying to understand whether to go down the biomedical sciences route or the medicine route directly, I'm going to tell you kind of the pros and cons of both to help you understand which way is best for you and how to decide the right route to go. Because what I'll talk about really is that when you go down the biomedical sciences route, there are often a few reasons people might do it. Now, one, usually this is because people maybe haven't got into medicine or medical school and they are then considering what they want to do as an option. Now, that is probably what we're going to discuss because that is usually the reason that people are coming and weighing up between those two. However, what I will say, the biomedical sciences route does offer a lot of career prospects beyond that, and I'll put them all up here. But it's usually something along the lines of being a research scientist, data scientist, maybe you want to go into a corporate, like a company or a big pharma company, and want to be a scientist for them. And definitely the corporate route and the latter routes will make you a lot of money. But normally the decision really is, I want to go into medicine eventually, and maybe I didn't get the A-levels or didn't get a place this time, and I want to consider going the indirect route via biomedical sciences, and I'm going to tell you how to decide whether that is a good option for you or whether you might want to consider taking a year out and reapplying again. So usually when people are making this decision, it's because they haven't got in and they want to get into medicine. So really they're deciding whether I want to waste a year, which is something that people worry about, because usually it's a 5 or 6 year degree to get into medicine, and then adding an extra year to that means that it's a little bit longer before they can start seeing patients and obviously being a doctor and doing the thing that they are ultimately aiming for. Now, the worry is that they will apply again and they didn't get in once, so they think, oh, well, you know, there's no guarantee that I'll get in this time. But I will give you some reassurance that we get this every year. People in the FutureDoc program, they come to us because they didn't get a place, and then they come to us for their second attempt and we get them in, partly because they didn't realize the mistakes that they're making, they didn't realize where the bar was, they didn't prepare properly. So understanding that and having that experience second time around can really make a massive difference. So in a typical year, anything from a fifth to a quarter of people applying are people who aren't applying for the first time. So it could be their second, third, fourth, even beyond number of attempts. But really the bigger question is, what if I want to go down that biomedical sciences route? What are the implications and what are the options available to me if I have that extra degree? So I'm going to try and help you decide whether it's worth going down that biomedical sciences route, because what I would say is it does give you a few benefits, but it also does make the process a little bit harder for some people. Because what happens is obviously you get an extra degree, you gain some skills as well, you become a lot more in tune with the scientific research side of things. People end up having a background in, like, they'll have done a thesis, they'll have got a lot more involved with research than your typical medical student would emerging from medical school. And if you want to be a doctor who is also involved in research, this does form a good background for it. But I would suggest and I would urge you to think, what is your reason for doing this? Is it because you don't want to waste a year? Or is it because you actually want to gain some skills and maybe would consider an alternative career in biomedical sciences, in those careers that I talked about, without, if you didn't get into medicine? Because it is more challenging. People think, oh, well, I don't want to waste the year. But actually, let's say you're in a position where you don't get a place at medical school, and then you go down the biomedical route versus the alternative of whether you just, you know, take it on the chin, regroup and reapply again to medicine the next year. That one, you lose a year of progress, so to speak, quote unquote. I think there are many things that you can do in that year that are incredibly beneficial to your career, whether that is as simple as going traveling or something like that. I talk about that, whether I should take a gap year, in this video here. Those are incredible life skills that are valuable for medical school and beyond, and something that I did. I got my place at medical school, then did a gap year. After being accepted for my place, I requested to extend the entry time and went traveling, and it was one of the best things that I did for my medical career. So that's something that really kind of ends up being a bit of a moot point sometimes. It's not even necessarily the most important thing that people worry about. Now, but let's say time is the most important thing and you want to save time and get through your medical career as quickly as possible, well, going down, taking an extra year is a lot quicker than going down that 3-year course and then taking another, you know, having to apply after that. So of course, if you do that and end up going down the graduate route after getting your biomedical degree, then in theory, you're saving a year because obviously you're doing 1 year shorter course on the medicine side. But that is assuming that A, you get in first time round, and B, that you get into one of the graduate courses rather than a lot of graduates still go via the 5-year course anyway. Because that is one of the biggest considerations. Remember that going into medicine as a graduate entrant is a lot more competitive than going as an undergraduate. So it's not even guaranteed. And on the FutureDoc program, we get many students who come to us as grads. About half of our applicants are grads because they have done this. They are on this cycle of applying to medical school, not getting in, doing it alongside a job, so then maybe they'll do it next year, and they kind of end up on this cycle, and they come to us because they've sometimes been on 3, 2, maybe even 4 attempts to get into medical school and are struggling to get in because it's so competitive. And then we've helped them get in on that time, because a lot of the time it's about how they structure their application and all that sort of stuff. But what I'm trying to say is it's not this, you know, pound for pound measurement that people make sometimes of like, oh, well, it's 1 more year, but I get a degree. But it brings me back to a common question that I always encourage you to ask, which is, why are you doing this? If you are doing this because you love scientific discovery, you want a door into maybe some research, or you want to get into biotech, whatever it is, then great, that's a fantastic option. But we just have to be real about, are we going into this because we think that it is a stepping stone to medicine, or that it is going to give us some skills in our arsenal that are later going to benefit us as a doctor? So let's do a quick side-by-side comparison. So if we're going down the medicine route, it's about 5 to 6 years to get where we want to be. If we're including the bioscience degree in that, it can be 7 to 9 years. Bear in mind on the medicine side that if you are probably in a position where you're thinking about biomed because you didn't get a spot, then maybe add a year to that. So it's maybe not as big of a gap as we might think. Cost is a really significant thing as well. Bear in mind that university is expensive, both the fees for the tuition and also living. Also, bear in mind that it might not be, if you don't get on the 4-year grad course, you might not be eligible to a student loan. These are subject to change, but sometimes the financing is one of the saddest things, because people get a place, they get an offer, and they realize that they can't afford to pay for it or can't afford to live. So graduate, the lifestyle is a really important thing as well, because grads, it's very different. I did both a undergraduate degree in medicine, and then I did a graduate degree in dentistry. And those are two very different lifestyles. In the first one, whatever your first degree is, you will be a lot more like a typical student enjoying a student lifestyle, versus when you are doing it as a second time around. You're a little bit older, you're a little bit more mature, you probably aren't quite living the same type of way, but often people have to support themselves as well financially. So it means that they are working a lot more alongside doing their studies. And then there's obviously career flexibility, but here we are talking about somebody in the context of doing biomedical sciences with the end result of ending up as a doctor. So something to bear in mind, but there are options for the person who does have that biomedical sciences degree. Not that you can't do them with just the medicine degree, but they do have a bit more experience, probably have a few more contacts from their degree, and they do have a bit more of a foot in the door to get involved with research alongside their medical career. And also, as a biomedical scientist, you have that backup of going into a science-based degree, whether it's in the NHS, data science, whether you want to go into a big company and maybe try and earn a lot of money doing that. You know, there are lots of things, there are lots of options available to you if you go down that route. Ultimately, it simply comes down to, what do you want? What strings do you want to have to your bow? Where do you want that endpoint to be? We've helped hundreds of people get into medicine, both directly who were thinking about going down the biomedical route, and those who have gone after the biomedical route, or even those who have done that and then had years of experience in research and then wanted to take that further by getting a degree in medicine. But what I'd like to reassure you with is that although there is a time implication and a cost implication, some will add more strings to your bow, but there are still satisfactory routes for a lot of people, and they both lead to great outcomes. So I wouldn't put too much pressure on yourself. And if you still really want to get to medicine or have a degree in biomedical science with a scientific career, you just need to plan strategically and think about some of the things that I've said. If you want a free guide for how to get into medicine, whether you're applying as a grad or as an undergrad, check out the link in the description where you can get one that FutureDoc have made that's going to help you. If you want our help with the application, you can check out this video here. But I would love to know, based on this, if you have any questions that you want to put in the comments below that we always answer, or if it's helped you decide either way, whether this has swayed you from one to the other or helped convince you more and more that this is the particular option that you had in mind is the right way to go. If you want our help, as always, you can join the FutureDoc program, but otherwise, thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.